All right, in part two, we are going to discuss the one tail and two tail test. And so far, what I have done, if you may notice, I only have done just one single hypothesis, one single type of the hypothesis. Right? It is always in the form of mu greater than or equals to some number. Let's say it's mu zero. Okay, so that means we believe it is there. And so maybe it is there. But it should not be that too far. So that's the image that we have so far. Right, but that's because, you know, to make it easier to carry out the computation, right? Just make it in this form always and repeat that again and again. You're gonna have the idea that okay, the rejection area is always on the left. But of course we can have different kinds of now hypothesis, like there are actually three forms. Like it can be greater than or equals to, it could be less than or equals to. In this case, we believe that the average should be less than some value, right? Or we might believe that the average is equals to some values. Okay, so now we are going to discuss two other forms of now hypothesis. And obviously gonna have a similar interpretation, like as long as you understand what we believe, right, and when we reject those hypotheses. Oh, and the name for that is one tailed and two tailed, one or two. And so let's take a look at the hypothesis first. And so we have that, like that's all what we always have, like that mu is greater than or equals to some number. And so we have that. I think I repeat that again. Yes, we have the mu zero there. So we already reject if the sample of if the sample is far, if too far to the left, or if the p value, or if the pink, this pink area is too small. But this one has a name. The name is the left tail test. I mean, we test for the possibility of the sample being on the left tail. The tail, which is on the left. It is called a tail because it's, if you plot a graph, this one it should be pretty thin. And that's the body, that's the tail, that's another tail. And we test for the left tail. If there's a left tail, you can guess what happens next. Like we can have the right tail. The right tail is when we will believe the average is there. Or you believe that the average should be there or something smaller. If this is what you believe, that means the evidence that will be against your belief would be the evidence that is on the right of the tail. You believe it should be on the left. And that means you would reject your belief, or you would reject your hypothesis if the sample actually shows that the sample mean is on the left instead. And if you believe that the average is 20 or smaller, and you perform the experiment, you collect samples, and the average turns out to be 25, that means what we believe in the first place seems to be false. And so we can do that, but that means the original hypothesis has to be in the second form, in the other form instead. That means let's believe that the average is less than some value, mean zero. Remove 20 first. If your now hypothesis is in this form, that means we have this image instead. We have this graph where we believe in the sample if it's on the left or close to the right. And we reject that when the mean is too far to the right. And this test is, of course, has a name. The name is the right-tailed test. We test whether the sample mean is on the right. And that has to... we have to start from this hypothesis. Right? And eventually, and finally, we have left, we have right, and we have two-tail. Two-tail is when you believe... Oh, actually, let me go to the next one first. Yeah, that's the left tail. We have the same image that we have that we showed before. It agrees, so we are cool with that. This is slightly too small, so we are still cool with that. We will test when it is on the left. Since we want to test the error to the left and the p value is compute using the less than. We want to test whether the random variable is less than that point. And that is when we have the greater than or equals to in the null hypothesis. And if we flip the symbol, that means we believe the average is on the left. And that means we have the mirror image of what we had before. If it is there, if the sample average happens to be there, that means we are happy. And that agrees with our hypothesis. So we do nothing. We do not reject it. If it is slightly higher than the null hypothesis, it doesn't agree. But still, it is still possible. It is still not unlikely to be that simple. So we still do not reject. We have the same decision on both cases. And if it's too far to the right, then this is where we reject the hypothesis. And that's the idea. And the math is you simply test by computing the area to the right of that point. It is, if you remember, that's the C score. So that can be the point there. And you find the area there at the p value. And if that area or that p value is too small, then this is when you reject. And the next one is the two tail. Let's not focus on the formula. Let's focus on the image below. And so if in this case we have the null hypothesis in the form of that the average is equal to some value. Remember that it is impossible to get a sample mean that is exactly that value because there are infinitely many possible values. So when we write this way, what we actually mean, as statisticians actually mean is the mu is close to or is about that value. The formula is equal sign, but what we actually mean is it is roughly that value. And it means what happens is if this is what we believe it is close to the mu zero. That means if it is actually close to mu zero, then again it means we are happy with the result. We believe it is mu zero, and the result is not too far from mu zero. Then in this region, we would not reject. And that means if we reject if it is not close. And in this case, when we say it's not close, there are two ways to be not close. It can be too far left or too far right, as you can see from this image. We reject in two areas. And when we reject, if the p-value is too far to the left or too far to the right. And the question is how do you compute the p-value? Because you have to go back to the concept of the p-value. We want to set up the p-value so that this one is the error. We want to make a small error. Let's say we want to be correct 95% of the time. And usually when we have the image that we have in the first place, when we have the left tail test, then we say that this error, the error to the left, it should be small enough, let's say less than 5 to reject. And then if the p value is in this region, or in this case about like 0.95, then this is the cases where we are confident that the null hypothesis is still true. And so that's the idea of the p value for the one tail test, right? But in this case, But you can see that the area that we will reject is both on the left and on the right. But that means what we want here is we want the do not reject area to have, let's say, 95 or 0.59 or 0.95. We want to be correct 95% of the time. Right, that means the area to the left and to the right is now split. We want the area to be less than 0.5. That means we want the area to the left to be less than 0.25 and the area to the right to be less than 0.25 as well. Right, so that so that's why the p value here, the p value that we compute for the two tilted, right, needs to consider both left and right regions. And so okay, and now we have that idea. So let's go back to the formula. Right, so we have two formulas there. Right? We have first, this is the concept. And the p-value now has to take into account of both the area to the left and the area to the right. To the right. So that's why the formula here is slightly more complicated. We have the absolute values on both sides. And then the left is less than minus on the negative part of that value. Then area to the right is greater than the positive part of that value. And if you remember, when we have the normal distribution, the areas, the regions are symmetric. So if these two points, right, are the same numbers, one with a negative, one with a positive part and one with a negative part. And let's say that plus 0.2. And that's minus 0.2. If those numbers have the same magnitude, right, that means the area, this orange region and this orange region have the same area. Right, so that means these two areas are the same. So that means we can simply compute just one. In this case, let's choose the positive one, right, and then multiply that area by 2. And so the two-tailed test has slightly more complicated, but if you go back to the rejection area, you will see why we have to multiply that by 2. If you want to be correct 95% of the time, and then we have to split these two areas into half. And so make sure you add that too, and make sure you understand that this equal sign actually means the approximation. And so that's that's the difference between left tail, right tail, and two tail. And next, we are going to see how we can perform the full hypothesis testing.